Where are we going, Dad? What's going on?
We're going to go and get our boat inspected and then cleaned, and apparently they pressure wash it. They got some big yellow tanks here, some kind of stuff.
And, you sound all professional when you start talking to the camera.
Welcome back. Can you guys be on camera? Do you want to be on my YouTube video? What's going on? Where are we right now? What is this?
So this is our watercraft inspection station.
Yeah.
And you know, this is set up by the government of Manitoba. So we inspect all watercrafts to prevent the spread of aquatic invasive species, which includes zebra mussels, spiny water flea, black algae, etc.
You're good. You didn't even know you were going to be on camera today. That was great. Well, we're going fishing in Northern Manitoba and we got to get our boat checked. My boat was last, or cleaned actually. My boat was last in Lake of the Woods, which is
not clean.
Not clean.
Yes.
Lake of the Woods has zebra mussels. That's good. I put you on the spot.
So we're going to decontaminate your boat. This is our decontamination unit. And we have, this was specially designed for this operation. So we have like hot water, which
How
is
hot?
60 degrees Celsius.
Ooh.
So we're going to spray your boat, especially the lower parts of your boat. So spiny water flea, it has this tendency of sticking on any surfaces such as the carpets. And then it could also go up your motor.
Mm.
So we're going to do a motor flush. We're going to put the muffs at your motor. And the whole process is going to take 15 to 20 minutes. We're going to also write you a receipt which proves that your boat has been decontaminated. And then we're going to put a green tag on. So if you pass through any other station or if any conservation officer checks you, that is a proof that your boat has been decontaminated.
Perfect. Awesome. How's it going?
Good, you? Love your videos, man.
Thank you so much. We got the green seal. We're all clean, thanks to the wonderful people here. So guys, there's a lot of info you can find online. I'm gonna link it below. Lots to learn. You need to know, you know, what your compromised water bodies are. That's the like Lake Winnipeg, Red River Watershed, Lake of the Woods. They have, you know, zebra mussels and have spiny water fleas. I can't even list them all off. Link below. I'm learning more about it. It's still a process. I'm trying to get more educated with all of this, but we all gotta do our part. There's check stops all over Manitoba. They've got all the times listed. So, you know, you might have to plan your trip around stopping by one of these. It takes, you know, that took whatever, 10, 15 minutes. Our boat is clean and we are off to Northern Manitoba.
Well, like 8 hours later from our check stop, and we made it to Viking Lodge on the Cranberry Lakes. This is Cranberry, first Cranberry. Second Cranberry, there's third Cranberry. There's a whole chain of lakes you can fish here. I probably look like a train wreck right now. I didn't get too much sleep. We've got a big day ahead of us. If you look real close, there's a boat coming across the way, and that's the competition this week. There's a guy named Clayton Schick. He's got a YouTube channel.
Try an active jig and a minnow and a dead stick jig and a minnow.
It's pretty good. You should check it out. He wants to go head to head against me. A little showdown, a little Clay versus Jay. This is number 3. I won the first one, Clayton won the second one, and we decided to meet on the same lake for the third one. Look what the cat dragged in, all the way from Saskatchewan. CSO Clayton Schick Outdoors.
Coming for you, Jay. It's not good for you.
So,
it's not good.
Clayton was pre-fishing yesterday, which is fair. I've spent time on this lake already, but you caught a couple walleye. There's a little smack talk on Instagram. Good luck, buddy.
It's bad for you, Jay. Bad things coming. I call this a guaranteed.
What do you got rigged up there?
Victory. Secrets. All secrets. Secrets.
Well, the beauty of Viking is we are so close to the launch. It is ugly out there. I don't know how much filming we're going to do, but we're going to be pre-fishing. Hopefully get my dad a couple big walleyes. My dad can catch all the big ones today. I want to catch the big ones tomorrow because that's going to be the competition against Clayton. It's going to be 5 biggest walleye. And I think it's going to take some pretty big fish to win. Anyways, going to the launch. We made it back. We got some walleyes filleted. We got some catch and cook. We are gonna fry up some walleyes in our nice cabin here.
at Viking Lodge. Dad, who's going to win tomorrow?
Well, I'm sure you are. I have confidence. Even though he, you know, whooped you today, I think you have the ability to get back and...
Hey, today doesn't matter.
Today doesn't matter.
And do your thing.
Stop it. Clayton, we were chatting throughout the day. Clayton said that for his five biggest, he was averaging around 26 inches. So that was better than we did. We did a lot of driving around, a lot of scouting, but we're going to talk more in depth about our game plan for tomorrow, setups, what we're doing, what we're looking for, but now we are going to cook some walleye.
It's rolling. We rolling? We're rolling. Guys, this is it today. Pan over there. We're on the same lake. Clayton Schick from Clayton Schick Outdoors.
Hi, Jay. Hi, Jay's cameraman dad.
I'd like to apologize for what I'm about to do to Clayton. All right, get back on me, Too much screen time for Clayton. We're on the Cranberry Lakes in Northern Manitoba. We're going for our five biggest walleyes. We have, I think it's 11 hours. We gotta be back here at, we're back here at 6:30, Clayton? Back here at 6:30. It is just about 7:30. We got like 30 seconds till blast off. We just gotta idle through the snow wake zone, but it's gonna be good. Best of luck to Clayton. And hopefully my dad doesn't beat both of us.
5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna pass him.
Welcome to Clay versus Jay. We are out here. Clayton is like within sight of me. He's at one of the spots I fished yesterday. Just shows you he doesn't have any spots of his own. He obviously saw me on it. Well, the wind shifted a bit. It was screaming yesterday into the shore. Now it's not. But we'll see how long it's gonna take. I'm using a jigging wrap. I'll show you what that's all about in a minute. So today we're doing something called sharpshooting. If you've watched any of Aaron's or Clayton's videos before, you've definitely seen it, sharpshooting. I think it might be like a European thing, but it's like marking individual fish and dropping down on them. That's what we're gonna try to do all day. As you can see, I got a new little toy, Garmin LiveScope. Yeah, I watched enough of Aaron's videos and I'm like, okay, I need to get it. So, just picked it up. I got it like a week ago, still learning the ins and outs. But it's a cool tool. I got the GoPro filming it, so you'll hopefully see some interaction with some fish eating my bait. Right now, I'm just focusing on trying to find some fish. There's a nice one. What we saw yesterday is the walleyes were pretty tightly bunched together. Oh, there's a walleye down there. Look at that fish darting around. Look at him darting. I'm gonna catch this one. Oh, he ate it. Oh, he ate it. I need this. These fish are in a little bit of a different spot than yesterday. Oh, there we go, we're on. First fish, Clay versus Jay. My dad is not allowed to net any. He's just a fly on the wall. And this guy, come on, you're kidding me. This should be worth bonus points. A Laker. A lake trout, the first fish in the walleye derby was a lake trout. We didn't catch a single lake trout all of yesterday. There's a couple, okay. There's a fish there and a fish there. Oh, they're coming for me, this is gonna happen. Come on. Yep. Oh no. Oh, he's coming back. There's a bunch of aggressive walleyes down there. Come on, it's gonna happen. I'm gonna see them darting and weaving. I'm gonna lay a waypoint right here. We're on a pot of fish. There's like 4 or 5 walleyes there. Oh. Here we go. Not big. This better not be another trout. No, I'm not, I don't even know. I guess I'll measure that guy. All right, walleye number one, going on the board. 14 3/4 inches. Not good. I'm not even writing that one down. I'm not even writing him down. Now, there's a lot of fish down here though. Oh, you have one. Dad's on. Let me know if you need a net. Yeah, most of our time today will be spent 20, 30 feet and kind of, yeah, main lake humps, little shelves near deep water. I think being near deep water is pretty key for big fish later in the year. Yeah, but these fish can move around so much with the wind, so it's really laid down now. I'm a little bit concerned, but it's the same for Clayton too. There's one, that's better. Hooked up with our first little bit better fish. Still don't think it's the right class. What we need, but we'll see. Jigging wrap in the side of the face. 18 incher, 14 3 quarters and 18 inches. Still not there, guys. So here's the deal. This is a jigging wrap. Big, heavy, very dense bait. And when you rip this thing, it just darts left, right, and it just has a crazy glide, and it's a reaction bite. My dad's using a drop shot with crawlers, drop shot with minnows. It's something you can hang right in their face. They have a chance to smell it out, so it's good for fussy fish. It's good for finicky fish, but I'm looking for a reaction. I'm just trying to like trigger something in him that he's like, I need to snap this. I need to eat this as quick as possible. And it's such a great big fish bait. Yeah, we're gonna see if we can get back on top of a couple of those fish. There's two big ones there. I'm gonna catch one of them. Oh, there's a third one that just ate my bait. Oh, I just lost another one. There we go. This feels good. Yep, this feels good. Come on, baby. He's barely hooked. Oh, yeah! Coming for you, Clay! There you go, number one. Let's throw it on the board. It's actually not gonna be as long as I thought. 23 and a quarter. Just fat, I thought he was bigger. All right, there's a little shelf that sticks off this island. Kinda, it's a little 20 foot flat and then drops off into like 80 feet, so we're gonna be fishing right in that 20 foot nook. Marked lots of fish here yesterday, worked them a long time, finally got one to bite. It was a good size walleye, so hoping that they're still here and that they're a little more willing to bite. Oh, I got him. Oh, I lost him. Oh, that was a big fish too. I can still see him. He's coming back. Got him. This is a better fish, finally. Oh, I saw him just chase. That was so cool. Nice, nice. Still not exactly where we want to be, but like you get spoiled by the fishing here. Guys, if you want to catch a bunch of big walleyes, you got to get yourself up here. No, these are not greenbacks. These are beautiful Northern Manitoba goldbacks. And we got 21 and a half. Got him. That's better. Finally, this feels like a big fish. Man is driving around and there's one individual big mark. Oh, barely hooked. Another good one, guys. This fishery has so many fish this size and bigger. 22, 22 incher going back. Yep. Oh, this fish is angry. So tough to tell size. Oh no. Oh, it's gotta be a pike or a real big walleye. Oh. Oh, yeah, it's a pike. Short and fat. I mean, not that short. But hey, there's big pike in here. About a 30, I don't know, 34, 35 incher. Well, it is time to check in. Not happy with my performance. It's bluebird skies. It stormed last night. It was thunder, lightning, crazy storm, cleared up like right when we started fishing this morning. So, Clayton, I got 5 walleyes. I got 5. I hope you caught 5. Fishing's been tough. Caught a real nice pike, caught a lake trout. So, yeah. Anyways, I got 99.75 inches. Biggest fish is like 23 and a half. So none of them hopefully I'm gonna keep, but that's my update. 10:30, period one, done. All right, Clayton sent me a video.
Hey Jay, here's my update for you. Hopefully the wind noise is okay. A good news for you, I have 4 fish I want to upgrade. The bad news is I've had a pretty good start, not gonna lie. I sent you a text, my number's there. Biggest fish is 26 and 3 quarters right now, which nice. Is a good one. And I think I have a total of 119
Ooh.
3 quarters, so I have a pretty big total.
That's pretty good.
Hope you're doing okay. I've seen you a few times, you look like you're running around like you're lost maybe. You can always ask for help. I'm always here.
Oh, he's doing good. He got a big one, 26 and 3 quarters. But that can happen at any point. We got the pike figured out. There we go. Come on, be a walleye. Be a walleye. Looks like a walleye. That's decent, that'll definitely be a big upgrade. Well, still not the right class, but it's gonna be an upgrade. 21 and a half, 21 and a half. Just nice to be out here. You can have the point. Guys, this is the most fish we've marked all day, and unfortunately Clayton's within sight of us. Like, just this inside corner. He's on the tip of the point and we're on this inside nook, and it's just stacked. Think about tournaments and pre-fish as you practice in these areas, you find fish, and then the day before the tournament, you know, conditions change. And that's what makes the good tournament guys so good, because they can adjust. I'm not there yet, but I'm working on it. But it's amazing how quickly fish can move, disappear from where they were the day before. But you find a pattern and then you try to replicate it on other similar looking spots, try to find a spot that looks the same. There we go. Just lost them. They're biting. Just takes a bit. Dad's on. Nice to see you catch a fish, Dad.
Yeah, it's about time.
Oh, there we go. We are on fish. Chicken wrap, 20 incher. Bunch of nice marks in like 19 feet. There we go. Oh, geez, it's gotta be a pike. Oh my goodness. No, oh, it's a walleye. We are on him. We have found the spot that we're gonna beat Clayton at. 21 and a half, another upgrade. 21 and a half, Clayton Schick. Yep, they are snapping. We're on fish. Just need to get into that right size. Oh, the hook popped. Don't put it in my leg. So, one of my favorite parts about the Cranberry Lakes is even on a crazy windy day, you can still fish. Some clear water and Athpap, amazing lakes, but when it's really windy, sometimes, you know, you're stuck to fishing some of the smaller lakes. This, we got big wind today and it's still very fishable. Lots of islands, lots of shelter. We're catching walleyes. Paul from Viking just texted me. He's gonna be delivering pizza, and he's delivering pizza to Clayton too. There we go. This feels good. Come on. We don't have a single fish that's bigger than any of Clayton's. Ooh, this feels good. Oh, this feels good. Come on. Yes, that's more like it. Right there. We are gonna win it on this spot. There we go. I'm thinking probably closer to 24. We need a bigger average, but this is still great. That's a good upgrade, but still not there. 23 incher. Here we go. Man, we have figured a pattern out. I wanna say this feels like the biggest fish yet, but maybe it's like hooked in the belly or something weird. Sometimes with those jigging wraps, those fish just smack at it. Ooh, ooh. Yes. They're getting bigger. This is a chunk. Look at this big fat walleye. Man, guys, the amount of quality fish, I can't get over it. 25 and 3/4. This big beauty is going back. Tournaments are just so much strategy. It's making decisions on, you know, what you think is the best spot and, you know, camping out on it. It's decisions. It's all about decision making. This is a spot I hadn't pre-fished at all. I'd fished it a little bit last time I was here, and I don't know if I did great on it, but it's a known big fish spot, and the wind has just been screaming into it. So I'm seeing so many fish, and you know, just sorting through them, 21s, 22s, and now we got that one. I wanna get five that size. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the setup I'm using. As I mentioned earlier, jig and wrap. I switched to a blue and silverish one. I saw the fish spitting up a lot of Cisco type bait fish in the live well, so I thought, hey, a nice natural looking color might be good. This is 15 pound fluorocarbon. A little bit heavier, just this is a real aggressive technique. Sometimes those hook sets catch you off guard, so 12 or 15 is good. We're going to 15 pound braid, and then I'm fishing this on a little bit of a longer rod. Don't want too stiff of a rod for this. I'm using a 7.3 medium with a fast tip. Another rod that I like to use for this is my 7.5 medium light. It's like an all-around walleye rigging rod, but it works nice for these ripping style baits because it's a nice soft rod. Too stiff of a rod will pull these hooks out. Even this one's maybe a little bit stiff, but it has good backbone too. 3000 size Stratic, and yeah, we're spot locked and just moving from pot of fish to pot of fish. Yeah, things, I'm feeling good. Feeling good, every upgrade feels so good. Look at all the fish down there. It's just an aquarium. Oh, this fish is gonna eat. And it's gonna be big, oh no! Another one coming back, huge mark. Yes, yes. This was such a big mark. Ooh, big head shakes. Big head shakes. It's gotta be a pike. It's running too much. What is that? That's a huge laker. Huge laker. Oh my goodness. Oh, that's big. This might be a master angler laker. I'm not even mad. This is the coolest part about the Cranberry Lakes, is you get big lakers mixed in with the walleyes. Clayton and I talked about potentially adding a lake trout category to this tournament, to this Clay versus Jay, and we're like, oh, let's just do straight walleyes. Right now, I wish this laker was worth something. Oh, that's a big laker. Look at this. Wow, walleye fishing. All right, we're gonna throw it on the board. It's probably gonna be like 32 inches. I don't think this will make master, but that was such a battle. It is 33 3/4. All right, one more look. We're gonna get this fish back real quick. Just under 34 inches, 33 3/4. I wish it was a walleye, but that was so much fun. She's tired. That was a good fight. All right, took her a bit. She was kicking. Back to the depths. Pretty cool, that's a pretty cool bonus. I got no problem with that. We're still gonna beat Clayton on the walleye side of things, but that's the potential here. Big lake trout, big pike, we found out a bit of everything today. Took a while, dad's hooked up. Do you have 5 yet for the tally?
No, not yet.
Show me.
This is only number 3. I know.
And this one's going in the well. Nice, dad's on. He's got it. Proud of you. Well, I think we got a special delivery. Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
This is not meant to be an ad, but they make really good food at the kitchen at Viking Lodge, and we didn't put them up to this. Paul just texted me, he said, what's your favorite type of pizza? I'm gonna deliver some pizza to you guys. So here we have it, ham and pineapple on the cranberries. Half the battle is just locating the fish, and this is the best spot I've seen in, I spent 4 days here last fall, or 3 days, and then yesterday. So this is the best spot I've seen in like 5 or 6 days of fishing here, like most fish I've ever marked, so. Oh, that's got some decent head shakes. Dad, you might have to hand this fish over to me. Ooh, that's a nice one. Oh, I needed that one. That's big. All right, put him on the board. I wanted that one, Dad. I needed that one. That would have been an upgrade. 24 in a bit. Well, Clayton, I ate a whole pizza basically, so I'm feeling pretty good. I got a big lake trout. That was cool. 33 3/4 inch. Bunch of big pike. Yeah, walleyes. I think we upgraded every single walleye. We're at 119. Biggest walleye is 25 3/4 inches.
Hope this isn't too windy, Jay. The pizza delivery was amazing. Thank you so much to Paul and Matt from Viking Lodge. That was awesome. And Jay, my biggest fish is still that 26 3/4. I've been upgrading though a little bit. My new total right now is 126.75. I've seen you on the same spot for like the last period. So I have a feeling you've made a big comeback. Definitely interested to see your results. A little nervous too. Good luck to you in the next period, but I hope I win.
Come on, we need a bite. It's been a bit. Oh, that was a bite. Wow. That was good timing. We need upgrades. Upgrades, upgrades. We have like one fish that I'm happy with. Oh, that's definitely an upgrade. Come on. Yeah. Yes. Oh. That is more like it. We got 27. We got 27. This is it. The game's changing. And Clayton won't know until he sees the video. 27 incher. Man. There we go. That was a good bite. That was a great bite. Oh, okay, Dad, reel in. We need three upgrades. I got two fish I'm real happy with. And this one is probably another one of those. No, don't do that. Don't like the big head shakes. Oh, that's big. Oh, that might be the biggest one yet. Oh, yes. I think that's the biggest one yet. I don't know, it's close. We're battling through the wind and the waves at Viking Lodge, and we are catching big walleyes. Nose touching, 26. That's all right. All right, one more look at this 26 inch stud. That fish is just thick. Come at me, Clayton Schick. Get away, leave, shoo, go. It's a big lake, Clayton, big lake, and you got a fish right beside me. This is the spot. This is the secret spot.
Two more 30 inchers and I'm going home, Jay. Miss you.
Got him. Oh, baby, come on. We need two upgrades at least. Hopefully this is one of them. Played with this mark for a long time. I could see him just chasing. I don't like where he's coming up. That's a big walleye. No, yes! Oh, one bite left. What an amazing showcase of this fishery. All of these big walleyes. 26 touching. All right, 26, one more look. The other camera died. One bite left, guys. What is going on? That's good. That means we surpassed what Clayton had for his last check-in, right? So now who knows? Now I know that there's a chance that we could win. But Clayton's pretty good. Guys, I gotta talk about the spot on the spot. We've been doing a lot of driving around and I can't stress enough. It's just like these humps, these big spots, that big point, wherever you might be catching the fish, there's always one sweet spot. This hump, we drove over it and I was just about to leave and I saw one little spike where there was kind of two fish hanging off and that's where I just caught that 26. So, oh, feeling good? Yeah, this might be it. Come on, big fish. Oh, he's pretty long. Oh, Dad, we did it. Clayton, you smell? All right, this is gonna be another cull going on the board. We wanted one more upgrade yet. Yeah, 25 and a half. All right, get the release here, Dad. 25 and a half, that is a pretty good upgrade. I think that's gonna give me another 2 inches. And I think we just hit 130 inches of walleye. I think that's over 26 inch average. You guys gotta come walleye fish here. This is just phenomenal. This was, so far we've been fishing for 9 hours? 9 hours of fishing. Ridiculous. Not using bait, all in artificial. So cool. Dad's hooked up. I need this fish. I'll pay you.
Should I hand it over to you? This reminds me of you at 14.
Stop it. They don't need to hear that story. Ooh, that is a nice long fish. Nice.
Yeah.
That's a long one. All right, throw him on the board. It's the biggest fish of the day. All right, that's a big old one for Dad. Nice. That would have probably sealed the deal for me, but I'm happy that Dad caught a big one. I got no complaints. It's now a hurricane out here, but my dad's hooked up. Dad making a comeback in the Clay versus Jay versus Dad. Oh, another big one. Another big one. Nice, hold a little bit higher, there you go.
All right.
24 and three quarters. 24 and three quarters. All right. All right, guys, we got about like less than an hour fishing time left. I want to give you a breakdown of our best spot. It was this point, this main lake point behind us. And I think one of the key things was access to deep water. Having deep water near it was important. This is, there's some deep water in these lakes, like 150 feet deep. So being near deep water, I think, was key to have a chance at a big fish. And then finding like little flats. Any of these spots with like little nooks, like it'd be, you know, come up to 80 and then there'd be a little shelf that'd be between 30 and 20 feet. And those seemed to hold the fish. Seemed like wind played a big factor. And that's why, even though I didn't pre-fish this spot, wind was pounding into it. I knew it was a big fish spot. So I'm gonna show you what it looks like on the map. You can see I auto-charted it quite a bit. And there you can see dark water, sorry, deep water, and then this nice little flat. So we kind of just worked back and forth along that ledge, looking for fish, spot locking, keeping the motor in reverse, and just sharpshooting. So yeah, 20 to 30 feet was kind of our, I mean, I know it's a pretty big gap. But we're marking fish right now. We're gonna drop down and we got like 45 minutes left to fish. Might get an upgrade yet.
Well, we tried to find some new spots on our way back in. We did not. We got to make the run back in. We got 15 minutes and we will go check in with Clayton. I don't know if we're gonna share results or not. Might just wait till the videos go live, but what a day. See you guys in a bit.
Stop talking to yourself!
Top 5 walleye. My question is to you, who do you guys think won?
I think Clayton got top 2.
I was definitely top 2. No, your dad.
Oh no.
I could have been third.
Alright, Clayton is staying over there at Caribou. I'm over there at Viking. A little friendly competition. If you guys want to find out who wins, you gotta watch. Well, if you watch this right now, you've watched till the end of my video. You gotta watch the rest of Clayton's video. Make sure you subscribe, guys. Northern Manitoba, Viking Lodge. Thank you to Matt and Paul and crew for hosting. Amazing times as always. And I will certainly be back. Don't forget to wear your life jackets. We'll see you next time.